Shalom, all praise to Yahweh, Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Waha Raka Kwidash, double honor to the apostles and the elders of the great millstone. Also, peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. Lord willing, this lesson will be edifying. This is going to be another quick lesson centered around the Most High being that ultimate warrior and having the perfect weapons of destruction. Now, the book of Exodus 15 and 3, the Lord, Yahweh Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, is a man of war. The Lord, Yahweh Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, is his name. And the Most High is the ultimate warrior. And him being that ultimate warrior as the almighty power, all right, Allah Shaja, that terrible demon-like power, the Most High have perfect weapons of destruction, all right, by him being that perfect warrior. Now, the book of Isaiah 54 and verse 16 tells us, behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, all right? And we all know an ancient smith was a swords maker or a weapons maker. He used to mend metal with fire, all right, by taking an anvil and a hammer and mending the metal out to make weapons, all right? But the Most High said, behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire. So the Most High is saying that I created the smiths that blows the coals in the fire. Now, modern day blacksmith, all right, would be German scientists, all right, or these scientists that have created these intercontinental ballistic missiles, all right. It says, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. All right, and that ultimate instrument for his work is the intercontinental ballistic missiles. Pursuant to the book of Revelation 9 and 16, 200 million missiles, all right, which is the army of the Lord by the Most High being a man of war. This is one of his perfect armies. All right, 200 million of them shall be cast upon America to ultimately destroy America by the way of fire. All right, and these are the works of the Most High. Why? Because the Most High is somewhat that ultimate warrior, all right, that has perfect weapons of destruction. It says, behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy, all right. And those intercontinental ballistic missiles are going to be the waster that shall utterly destroy America. And the Most High have created them. Why? Because he is the ultimate warrior, and he has the perfect weapons of destruction, all right? Now, the book of Psalms, chapter 17, and verse 13 tells us, O rise, O Lord, Yahweh Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, disappoint him, cast him down. Deliver my soul from the wicked, which is thy sword. Now, who is that him that we're praying to the Most High, all right, to disappoint and to cast down? Esau, Edom, all right, which is the wicked that the Bible speaks of. It says, deliver my soul from the wicked. And who is the wicked? The sword of the Most High. The so-called modern-day white race is the sword of the Most High. All right, starting with their top tier elites, okay, because they have the power, and the Most High is using these wicked elites as his sword, okay. Let's read it again. Psalm 17 and 13, arise, O Lord, Yahweh Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, disappoint him, cast him down, deliver my soul from the wicked, which is thy sword, all right, because this is another perfect weapon of the Most High. All right, which is the so-called modern-day white man, all right? The Most High have imputed a high level of wickedness upon this man and a high level of pride upon this man, all right, to do all the wicked and prideful and evil things that he do, all right, being the bloodthirsty man that he is, all right? Why? Because he is a sword of the Most High, and the Most High is about to unleash this sword upon the house of Israel, All right, pursuant to Jeremiah 30:7, the time of Jacob's trouble. All right, it's going to be race riots, okay, insurrections, okay, because the Most High is going to use his sword, all right, to cast all of these things into play, or put all these things into play, okay? The scripture tells us in the book of Ecclesiasticus, also known as the book of Sirach, chapter 39 and 28. It says, there'll be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them. And who you think made them, all right? The Most High, Yahweh, all right? Through his only begotten son, Yahawashah, all right? These are perfect weapons of the Most High. Let's read that again. There'll be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them, all right? It says, fire and hell and famine and death, all these were created for vengeance. Okay? So these are weapons of the Most High, all right, that he's going to send forth, all right? And that's going to start at the house of Israel, but it's going to overtake the world as a whole, all right? Why? Because he is a man of war, all right? And all our war is finna break out mainly on the soils of America, just like it has started in other parts of the world, but as a whole, all chaos, all right? And it's going to come by the way of a warrior, which is the Most High, all right? Now, the book of Second Ezra, chapter 16, and verse 3 speaks about, a sword is sent upon you, and who may turn it back? A fire is sent among you, and who may quench it? All right, now that goes back to Isaiah 55, all right, and 16, all right, speaking about the smith that blew up the coal in the fire. Now, we learned about the ancient blacksmith, and who is the modern-day blacksmith? These scientists, all right, mainly the German scientists that have created the elements to create an intercontinental ballistic missiles, all right? That is that sword that shall be sent, and no one is going to be able to turn it back. That is that fire that is going to be set among you, and nobody's going to be able to quench it, all right? So these are perfect weapons of the perfect man of war, which is Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shah. All right, now the book of St. Matthew's, matter of fact, let's get the book of Hebrews 4:12. Now, this is another weapon of the Most High. It says, Hebrews 4:12, for the word of the Most High is quick, meaning it's alive and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing sunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. All right, now that is a weapon, which is what? The word of the Most High. All right, it is compared to a what? Sword, because it is a weapon. All right, it pierced even to the dividing sunder of soul and spirit. All right, a carnal sword, a cut the flesh real deep. All right, but this right here, cuts all the way to the soul and spirit, all right? So that's an incurable cut. That's a cut that can't heal, all right? It says, and it is a discerner of thoughts and intents of the heart. So that's a weapon, okay? And when used right, it will show if an individual is wicked or righteous, all right? Now, Ephesians also compared The word of the Most High is what? A sword. All right? Ephesians 6 and 17. And take the helmet of salvation and the word, Salakia, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of the Most High. All right? So these are perfect weapons of a perfect warrior. All right? Now, Matthew 24 shows us how perfect that this weapon of the Most High is, which is the word, which is compatible to a sword or compared to as a sword. St. Matthew 24 and 14, it says, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. That's how powerful that the sword is, which is the word of the Most High. All right, it has been sent out via the internet, okay, to all kingdoms, to all people, all right, and it is bringing a closure upon the rulership of America and the world as we know it. That's how powerful the word is, which is compatible to a sword, which is a perfect weapon of a perfect warrior. All right, let's read it again. St. Matthew 24 and 14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. So this powerful word, which is the sword, which is a perfect weapon of the Most High, has went out and it has sliced and diced and accomplished what the Most High wanted it to do, which is bring the world as we know it to a closure. All right, which these are perfect weapons from a perfect warrior. Because the Most High is a man of war, all right? And a perfect warrior, all right, an ultimate warrior will have the ultimate weapons, all right, of perfection that shall bring destruction and death, all right? And all of these weapons are going to bring destruction and death, okay, from a perfect warrior, which is the Most High. So, Lord willing, I pray that made sense and that was edifying. Call Halal, Yehovah Ba'ashem, Yehovah Shah, Wahab, Rakah, Kwidash. I want to give double honor to my teachers, the apostles, and elders of the Great Millstone. Peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. DTA, Wa Abba Babal.